One of my biggest concerns going into Valhalla was stealth. How is Ubisoft going to address assassinations, social blending, things that really bring out the assassin fantasy? In my 3 hours of hands-on time with the game, I was able to tackle several locations using stealth, so I have a pretty good idea about how it all works. Here's every single detail you need to know about stealth gameplay in Valhalla. There's a surprising amount of depth in stealth, so much so that I think it's going to surprise people who are expecting a similar experience to Odyssey and Origins. It's a mix of new and returning stealth mechanics that makes things feel closer to how they were before the reboot. We can one-shot assassinate any enemy in the game, even bosses. We can patrol blend to infiltrate certain areas, and we can hide in plain sight, using our environment to blend with the crowd. I didn't get to use any of the social stealth mechanics shown during the new gameplay trailer, so let's take a closer look at those. First, we have patrol blending. Finally, we're able to blend with crowds again. Confirmed by a video linked below by 6keys, ˈeɪvɔːr can't blend with just anyone like the old games. It's restricted to certain zones or certain groups of people. Most likely, like we saw, ˈeɪvɔːr will have to find a group of hooded people in order to realistically blend in. We don't know whether this is a dynamic event that we're seeing, or we have to hire these people to walk into the city with us. It's possible these could be a group of assassins, or our Viking clanmates wearing cloaks. ˈeɪvɔːr can also hide in plain sight using the environment, something we saw in the earlier games. We see this bread-making animation with guards walking by, and another example of ˈeɪvɔːr eating at a table unnoticed. At the end of the clip, there is an interact prompt, so instead of just moving into these blend zones like the older game, we'll have to activate them manually each time we want to blend. It'll be interesting to see how many unique opportunities we'll have to blend in with the environment and how often we'll be able to do this. Restricted zones are back, and enemies will detect you very quickly if you're not hidden in these areas. But now there's new areas called distrust zones. These are designated by an orange border on the compass. ˈeɪvɔːr automatically puts their hood on upon entering a distrust zone. In these areas, guards are suspicious, forcing you to move around carefully and not staying in one place for too long. In Ubisoft's preview video, the narrator says ˈeɪvɔːr is not welcome in England, so I assume we'll be able to use social stealth only in these distrust areas. There might be a lot more going on with distrust zones, so it'll be interesting to see more gameplay of these sections. There's two primary ways to scout locations for stealth in Valhalla. Eagle vision returns in the form of Odin Sight. It's a pulse that reveals enemies around ˈeɪvɔːr, giving a faint red glow that you can see through walls. You can scout with your raven Synin too, but I wasn't able to mark targets like in Origins and Odyssey. I don't know if that's locked behind a skill or it's just removed from the game entirely, but it made me a lot more aware of my surroundings. I had to pay attention to where those enemies were instead of marking them and relying on the HUD. The biggest addition to stealth in Valhalla is the cloak. Holding down the D-pad opens the tool wheel, which lets you assign the cloak to that button. Then you can toggle your hood on and off at will. It has this really cool animation where it hides your shield and weapons. I didn't find any restrictions on when or where I could use my cloak, and I could activate it crouching or standing. And the only time the cloak comes off after activating it is when you're detected, when you're forced to pull out your weapons and fight. The cloak isn't just cool to look at, it has gameplay application too, because it reduces your detection range. I'm not sure what the exact distance is, but if I wasn't hiding in a bush or behind an object, enemies could see me with the cloak on from about 10 meters away. So don't expect to be completely invisible with this cloak on. From what I could tell, I don't think crouching alone reduces your detection anymore like it used to. Enemies will still spot you if you're just out in the open when crouched. Stalking zones are back in the same way that we had before. ˈeɪvɔːr can use bushes or high grass to close in on targets and assassinate them undetected. 6keys noticed there are patches of grass on rooftops that work like stalking zones, so you can hide on rooftops too. Haystacks are back, but this time you can assassinate from them too. I didn't get to do this myself, but here's a clip from Access the Animus that shows it in action. It's really cool to see that series staple return. And like previous games, you can whistle to attract enemies to stalking zones for the assassination. Just like the cloak, you've got to assign it from the tool wheel and then you can use it on command. Assassinations are performed by hitting the light attack button, and they can be activated from a pretty generous range. For example, if you're out of melee distance, it teleports you in range, often with a little leap or hop. If you're above a target, ˈeɪvɔːr will jump down for an air assassination. I wasn't able to test if dual assassinations are possible. Like Odyssey and Origins, there's a small window where you can still assassinate someone if they're in the process of detecting you. And if you pull that off, you won't blow your cover and get detected by other nearby enemies. In my demo, I was able to one-shot assassinate most enemies I came across. For the tougher enemy types, I had to use the new advanced assassination skill. This is a raven-based main skill that you can grab really early on because it only takes 8 skill points from the beginning to unlock. Here's how it works. If you're facing a stronger enemy and click assassinate, a quick time event automatically appears on the HUD. You have to press the button again when the white circle is within the red area. The tougher the enemy is, the narrower the zone gets. If you fail this minigame, you're automatically detected, but you still deal a lot of assassination damage. Again, this lets you one-shot stronger enemies, even bosses if you're able to sneak up on them. In my interview with game designer Jessica Maher, she confirmed that your ability to advanced assassinate scales with your power. So the stronger you are, the easier it should be to one-shot. There are tons of stat nodes in the skill tree that boost your stealth and assassination damage. These aren't limited to the raven trees either. I found a lot of stealth and assassination stat nodes in the bear and wolf trees. I could only find 2 different types of stat nodes that directly benefit your stealth and assassination damage. The first one is stealth training, which increases your stealth attack in ranged and melee. And then assassination attack training increases damage of assassinations. In addition to advanced assassination, other main skills in the raven tree will add to your toolset in stealth gameplay. Breakfall, for example, removes all falling damage, which helps you if you need to get out of sight quickly. Chain assassination lets you throw an axe at a nearby enemy right after assassinating another. There are tons of main skills that I didn't get to see, so there's bound to be more stealth-based skills to unlock. Range stealth feels very similar to what we had in Origins and Odyssey. You can open fights with an arrow, and if you're not seen, you can pick off enemies one by one without getting detected. According to 6 Keys, if you start aiming with a bow while you're in a stalking zone and a guard is looking your way, you will be detected. The predator bow is the best option for lining up stealth headshots. There's a skill in the raven tree called predator bow combo that increases damage on successive headshots. Guided arrow lets you control predator bow arrows mid-flight to line up headshots. There's also a skill in the wolf tree called emergency aim that allows you to quickly lock on to nearby enemies who detect you so you can take them out before fully blowing your cover. In terms of ranged abilities for stealth, raven distraction can be used to distract one enemy while you take out the other, and thorn of slumber puts targets to sleep, which opens them up to a potential assassination. It feels like you're allowed to approach a lot of open world activities stealthily, and Jorraptor's video confirms that you can technically raid locations stealthily before blowing the horn and activating a formal raid. You just have to go in by yourself and clear everyone out. It doesn't look like your Viking raiders can infiltrate like ˈeɪvɔːr can. Same goes with the assault encounters. These look like they will be loud no matter what. You can choose to be more stealthy by yourself, but again, I wouldn't expect to be able to do these large-scale assaults with your clansmen undetected. Other small details, enemies have visibility cones. So if they turn their head and it looks like their body's facing a different direction and you're visible, you're going to get detected. The AI seems about as smart as Odyssey and Origins. Not every single enemy in the area knows where I am if I kill one of them. It took time for them to converge and find me if I blew my cover. From what I could tell, the hidden blade only comes out for assassinations. You're not able to equip it like you could in the older games as your primary weapon. That's all the information we have right now about stealth, and we should expect to see more Valhalla before launch, so hopefully we'll learn more about blending and social stealth. And if we do, you can expect me to cover it here on the channel. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss my continuing Valhalla coverage. I'm working on exploration, story, combat, and skills videos just like this one, so stay tuned to the channel. For the rest of the video, I'm going to show you all of my unedited stealth gameplay so you guys can get a good idea of how it feels in the game.
See you, old friend. I feel great. That's better. Ah!
cold.
People of East Anglia have spoken the word. Give yourself up.
Flee, Emerald, while pity restrains my blade.
Not till I've taken all these.
Spread your wings, Synin. Synin, guide me.
Big thanks to my patrons, Bill, Grass, Casey, John, Kamal, Patrick, Spyro, Tom, and Jackie. If you didn't know, I have a Patreon where you can support me further in exchange for exclusive updates and behind-the-scenes content. Check out the link in the description below for more information. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.